Hi. All right. What's up, everybody? Kevin Doyle here, and this is my wife, Camie.
Hi.
And we are today going to be talking a little bit about GV marriage. And we are thrilled about offering our congregation and even those outside the opportunity to grow in marriage ongoing. We like to call it the middle. It's the middle time. The church, we've been really good at offering premarital counsel, those getting into marriage, jumping in for the first time. And then we do a good job also on the crisis side of things. So when we are struggling and on the way to, man, spiraling out of control, the church offers some great biblical counsel on helping couples get back to the basics. But this ministry is an ongoing ministry that we offer to couples to try to never get to the place of crisis.
Right.
So we want an ongoing ministry to help with communication, to help with conflict resolution, to help with just staying connected, really. It's the major point. Stay connected, stay together with everything that you're doing in this life. And so we wanted to give you a couple of tips on how to communicate better in marriage, huh, babe?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, we're not perfect at this, but these are things that we try to incorporate the best that we can in our marriage, and would just encourage you to try to implement things like this as well.
The key word is try.
Yeah, so work on it.
We're trying. You could be trying. Yeah, we'll get better.
Yes, we do. We do get better.
Yeah.
The first thing we wanted to bring up is in communication to one another, try never to bring up the proverbial always and never statements.
Right. Yeah.
So, like, you know, Camie, what would it look like or what would it feel like if I said, you always avoid real life topics?
I would get defensive right away and say, no, I don't always.
Avoid.
Yeah.
So, and maybe
always.
Even. Yeah, always. Always. But it's not
there
always.
There was one time I didn't.
Exactly.
So that's not always.
And you would defend yourself.
Yeah.
Just absolutely, as I would as well. Exactly. But maybe you've heard these words as well. Like, you always say stuff like that.
You always go and do your own thing.
And you always avoid us. Yeah.
What else?
Or you always spend money that you don't have.
Ooh.
Dang. Never feels good hearing stuff like that. Or even the opposite side of the always is the never. So, you never listen to me.
You never help around the house. Not one time in your whole life.
In your whole, oh, thanks. You never initiate sex.
Ooh. You never say,
babe.
I love you.
Oh. It's messed up.
It is messed up.
It is. It is. Or you never say, I'm sorry.
Mm.
Always and never statements. How do you incorporate those into your life? What's the problem with the always and never statements then?
They're not true. That's
a problem. That's I have that problem. Because it's not always true. But I think the other thing is, with always and never statements, you indict the motives of the person you're saying those things to. You think you know what it is that's going on in their heart and their mind, and it brings up issues. And most of the time, most couples aren't trying to go out of their way to hurt each other.
Right.
We have good motivation.
Yeah.
We have good, don't you
think?
So,
I do think that. Yeah. So, what should we do then instead of saying the always and never statements?
You ask more questions than make statements.
Yes.
In this life, it's better in marriage and really in any relationship that you have to ask more questions, being more inquisitive.
Right. Then we don't have to assume anything, because if we're asking our spouse, they're going to tell us exactly what they're thinking and how they're feeling. We don't have to come
at least
up
that's
with
the
that
hope.
Assumption.
That's
if
the hope.
If you're being honest with your spouse, which is the goal here, to be honest with your spouse, right?
Yeah.
That instead of just assuming, we're going to ask them, how does that make you feel? What is the truth? Tell me the truth, because maybe I don't know.
Like going back to the always statements, what if the statement you always avoid real life topics, what if it turned into I really want to have a conversation about real life topics and it feels like you avoid that.
Mm-hmm.
Are you trying to avoid those conversations with me? Like asking the question gives you the opportunity to speak freely and hopefully you would be able to answer with your heart.
Hopefully it's a no. I don't want to avoid the issues because I want to be able to connect with my spouse. I want to be able to talk about those issues head on so that we can better our relationship, we can understand one another more easily.
And even if you're a guy and you're like, well, I don't know how to say it,
yeah,
at least being honest to say, it might appear like I'm trying to avoid it, but I'm really not. I just don't know how to tell you
right,
without you getting upset, or I'm not sure how to communicate those heart-to-heart feelings, and so I just avoid it, and not trying to, but I just don't know how to communicate. Even saying those things are
being
hugely
honest.
Important.
We're being honest with one another.
And honest.
And there's with honesty, there's a sincerity that I believe the other spouse can appreciate.
Absolutely.
Even if the honest truth is, I don't know.
So what you're saying is that if you're gonna ask a question, you should be ready for the honest response.
Yeah, you really
that's
should.
That's what I hear you saying.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
For sure. If you're gonna be honest, say what you mean. Say what you mean.
And mean what you say.
And don't try to fluff it up at all.
Right.
In a good, healthy, ongoing, motivated to do the right thing kind of a relationship, it is about being fully honest and being fully able to communicate your heart, even if it's kind of negative. Even if it is, yeah, I avoid it with you because you fly off the rail when I talk about things that are negative, and you get so angry, and I'm trying to protect our relationship by avoiding you being angry. I don't want you to get angry. I want you to be happy, and so I just don't bring up those issues.
I think we also avoid things because it's painful to think about and experience. And so just avoiding it means you don't have to go there emotionally.
Right. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So if you're gonna ask questions, though, be ready for the honest response and be willing to honestly respond. So you have to choose. There's a couple of tips here. That's it. Couple of tips to choose to grow in the art of communication. There's so much and a vast amount of information that you can look up. But for us, we just wanted to touch base and give you guys a few tips that might be able to help in your relationship. And I hope that you might be interested in being a part of an ongoing ministry that will help you in the middle of your life.
In
the middle of the preparations, in the middle of crisis, that you would find a place that encourages you to be better at your marriage. So don't schedule over your marriage. It is an investment that's worth everything you've got, financially and your time. It's worth the investment. So listen, if you want to incorporate these principles and so many more, I encourage you to, in the middle, you've already been prepared for marriage. You never want to get to crisis. So in the middle of your relationship, be a part of an ongoing ministry. Commit to an investment into GV Marriage and come quarterly. And if you're interested in signing up for the next session, you can check out the description below, click the link there, and it will send you to a page. It will let you know all the information you need, the date, time, the cost, all of that stuff. So man, do it, and because your marriage is worth it, don't you think?
I do. It's
very
worth it.
Thanks guys so much. We'll see you later.
Bye, I'll see you later.